Welcome back. In today's lecture, I am going to talk about the definition and conditions for observability. So in the previous class, what we have seen that if some system is controllable or reachable, then it is possible to move from one point in the state space to another point, because we are able to understand what is meaning of controllability, what is meaning of reachability. Now in today's lecture, we are going to see another problem. And what is basic difficulty related to any control system design? That I have fewer number of output variable than the state variable, but during the control design, it is possible to show that if all states are available, then one can design the control system using any well-known design techniques. Most of time, if you design control system just based on the output information, and that is also called static feedback, so it is possible to show that particularly in higher dimensional system is not stable. And due to that reason, what people are trying to do, first they try to measure almost all state variable, but that is not feasible, because in order to measure each and every state variable, I need different sensors, and it means that I have to fuse different kind of sensors inside the system, and each and every sensors has its own dynamics sometime. So it might possible that order of system, overall order of system, after placing the sensors, our system become more complicated. So now what is another solution? Another solution is that suppose if I know the output variable, so what we are going to do now, that in place of the sensors, some kind of physical element, now we are going to create some kind of virtual program, and using that virtual program, we are going to estimate the other state variable. So sometime it is possible, sometime it is not possible. It means that if I know the output, then question is now like this: is it possible to measure all state variables? And at least for linear system, we have certain kind of criteria in terms of matrix. Then using that criteria, it is possible to show that if I know certain output, then using that output information, it is possible to measure the all other states. Similar kind of result people has extended for nonlinear system or other classes of system. In this course, I am going to limit myself just on continuous linear system. So now let us start the lecture. And in this lecture, I am going to prove that concept of observability is dual to the controllability. We will see what is meaning of dual here. And after that, what we have observed in the previous class, controllability studies the possibility of steering the state from the input, and observability, now whatever we are going to learn in today's lecture, that studies the possibility of estimating the state from the output. It means that if I have fewer number of sensors, and if I have certain kind of virtual program or computer program, so with help of these two, it is possible to show that I can able to estimate all other state variable. So sometime it is possible, sometime it is not possible. So in today's class, I am going to create certain kind of criteria. Using that, it is possible to at least give guarantee that if I know the output of linear system, then I can able to estimate all the other state variable which is not reflected on the output. So I have two different kind of things, and in this course you are able to learn both. That sometime people are telling that full order observer, sometime reduced order observer. So if I have information of the output, and if we are going to measure all state variable or going to estimate all state variable with help of output, then we have certain kind of algorithm, certain kind of program that is called full state observer. And I have again that reduced order observer. If some state is available on the output and remaining state, whatever remaining state, I am going to estimate using some kind of algorithm, some kind of computer program. So today, in today's lecture, I am not going to deal that part, means how to create observer. But at least we are going to create some kind of analysis. Using that analysis, one can able to give guarantee that observer design is possible or not. So let us start with the very simple system. So first part of lecture, I am going to cover continuous time, linear time invariant system. So I have taken x dot equal to ax plus bu as a system, and my output y equal to cx plus du. I am assuming that I have n number of physical variable, that is a state variable. U belongs to RP, means p number of control input, and y that belongs to RQ. Now let us first define what is meaning of the observability, means how to characterize the observability. Because in the previous lecture we have already seen the motivational example, several motivational example where loss of observability comes into picture. So first we will give some kind of concrete definition, and after that, based on that definition, we are going to create some kind of necessary and sufficient criteria for linear time invariant system. And using that criteria, without doing any kind of much calculation, just by seeing some kind of matrix criteria, I can able to talk about the observability of system, means system is observable or not. It means that from the output we are able to explore the possibility of estimate all state variable or some partial state variable. So definition is like this. The state equation of, this is a state equation of linear time invariant system, is said to be observable if for any unknown initial x0, because I am assuming that all initial condition is not known to me, then there exists a finite time t1 greater than 0, such that knowledge of input u and output y over some time, again that is finite time, and that is sufficient to determine uniquely the initial state x0. And try to understand the motivation again. Suppose I have this system and I want to see the future behavior xt. Or so how one can determine the future behavior? First they have to solve this equation. And how to solve equation? We have already learned how to solve this kind of equation. And what we have observed, that in order to solve this kind of differential equation, two things are required: initial condition x0 and control for all t greater than equal to t0, if we are able to estimate a state at t1. So it means that two information is always required to know the future behavior. And if I do not know the all initial condition, then I cannot claim that I know the future state of the some system. And due to that reason, if only output is available, it means that it is possible to show that sometime on output all state will not reflected. And you can understand like this. Suppose I have some mass and I have applied some force. We have already taken this example in the previous class. And if I apply some kind of control input, and if I have just measurement of velocity, then what we have observed that I cannot control the position. It means that I have to understand the value of velocity as well as position in order to control the all future state. And suppose if now only velocity is available, then we are going to look the possibility that is it possible to estimate the position or not. If we are able to do so, then I can tell that system is observable, otherwise not. So due to that reason, in this definition you can see that we are stating same thing. What we are stating? That unknown initial condition, because only velocity is known but position is not known. So initial condition of the position is not known to me, so I cannot claim that all state variable, because in whatever example I am talking now, that has two state variable, position and velocity, and using information of position and velocity and after applying Newton's law, I can able to talk about future state. Future state means future position and future velocity of the system. And if we are able to determine uniquely, that is very, very important. It means that, because what happens that if you see the engineering system, what is beauty about if I fix the control input and if I know the initial condition, then I can determine the future uniquely. So it means that if I apply ut and x0, then solution should be unique. Due to that reason, we are going to tell some system is observable only if we are able to determine uniquely the initial state. And due to that reason, inside this definition, uniqueness comes into picture. And otherwise, if we are unable to do that, then we are telling system as a unobservable. Similar kind of definition is also available for the linear time varying system. So definition doesn't change. Now let us try to first again try to revise one motivational example which shows that system is not observable. So I have taken one very simple circuit, and in previous class what we have observed that most of time whenever we lose the controllability and observability, one of the obvious reason is symmetry. So here I have some kind of symmetrical element about across this particular capacitor. Now you can see that if input equal to 0, if this is 0, no matter what is the initial voltage across the capacitor, you can take any initial condition here about this capacitor, the output is identically 0 because of the symmetry of the four resistor. And you all are electrical engineer, so you are able to understand this fact. And even if you are not electrical engineering, this basic electrical is taught to almost all branch. So it is very, very easy, pretty easy to check that if this is zero and you can put here any voltage, any initial voltage, but output y equal to zero. So we know the input and output both are identically zero, but we cannot determine uniquely the initial state. Because what happens that here in this whole circuit, I have just one dynamic element, that is capacitor. So if you write the differential equation, then I have first order differential equation. Now question is that if I know the output and I have defined output is the voltage across this plus this capacitor. So this is zero and this is zero, but I cannot able to predict unique value of this, and due to that reason we are telling that this network is not observable. Let us try to see another example. So here again, I have taken one inductor and here I have one capacitor. So I have two state variable because I have two dynamic element involved inside this circuit. And in order to check observability, first, it is very easy. You can apply U equal to zero and try to see that uniquely I can able to identify a state or not. If you are unable to do that, then system is unobservable. And so we are going to do same kind of things. So I have applied U equal to zero. It means that my system is now unforced system. And for linear forced system, I have already told you that complete response is the zero state response plus zero input response. So you can put all state equal to zero and after that apply input and try to see the what is output. And after that you can do same kind of process, that you can put U equal to zero and try to see the output due to the internal condition. And due to the property of linearity, I can tell that complete response is the summation of input response, zero state response plus zero input response. So here what I am going to do in this particular network, in order to talk about observability, first I am going to put U equal to zero. And if you put U equal to zero, then again it is possible to show that Y equal to zero. Now I have two state. One state is X1 and X2. So we are going to see that is it possible to observe X1 and X2 uniquely or not. If we are able to do, then system is observable, otherwise not. So what happens that I have two state, I have defined the state current X1 through the inductor and X2 across the capacitor. U equal to zero, I am going to do X1 equal to zero, X1 equal to A and X2 equal to zero, then also output is identically zero. It means that if X1 has some finite value and X2 equal to zero, then also output is always zero. It means that from the input output pair, I cannot able to predict this X equal to zero uniquely, because this should be unique. If uniqueness will lost, then we have already seen that there is no value of the engineering model. And here we are unable to do that, and due to that reason, we are telling that this particular network is unobservable. So this is just example. So we have seen the definition, we have seen some motivational example. Now let us try to see some kind of algebraic criteria in terms of matrix equation, that how to talk about the observability. So what we have seen in the class of controllability, I have some matrix in terms of system matrix A and B, and after that we are checking the rank of B, A, B, A square B, and after that we have talked that whenever we are talking about controllability, then there is no need to worry about the output Y. Here I have two known quantity. What is two known quantity? I know the output, I know the input, and then I have to predict the X0. So first try to see the solution. So if you see the solution, then this is our solution. And in this solution, I have already told you that whenever we are talking about the observability of system, then we are assuming that output is known to me, control input is known to me, and only unknown things is X0. So here you can see that this part is only unknown to me, CE power AT X0, because I do not know X0. So I have defined this part as a Y bar T. And what is Y bar T? Since this part is Y bar T, so I can tell that another part which is already known to me, that can be represented like this. So now observability problem I can express in terms of these two things. So I have some kind of algebraic equation c e power a t x 0 equal to y bar t, and we are telling that from this, is it possible to identify uniquely x 0 or not? If we are able to do that, then system is observable. Now you can see here I have substitute u equal to 0, because I have told you that I have to know the initial condition. So even if I have no control input, and if we are able to see that uniquely I am able to determine the initial condition, then also my system is observable. So y bar reduced to 0 input response. It means that if you substitute ut equal to 0 in this particular equation, then, and if I know the yt, then I can able to calculate the x0, provided some unique solution exists for this particular matrix equation. So this is matrix equation, because yt belongs to RQ. So please be careful. Now let us try to see that I can also state the definition of observability like this. The system x dot equal to ax plus bu, y equal to cx plus du, and here I am assuming that x belongs to Rn, y belongs to Rq, and u belongs to Rp, is observable if and only if, whenever we are stating any definition, then we are assuming, we are stating like this, and this is true for all definition. You can please check it. So whenever we are talking about any mathematical definition in field of mathematics or applied field, every definition gives this kind of sense, if and only if, then the initial state x0 can be determined uniquely from its zero input response over a finite time interval, because finite time interval is again equally important in this case of in case of observability also. So now it might possible sometime control is also present, then I have this definition will not work, and at that time my definition I have to solve this problem in order to determine x0 uniquely from c e power a t x0 y bar t. I have already defined this term. We must use the knowledge of ut and yt over a non-zero interval. Same is stated in next theorem. So this theorem, you try to see that in controllability I have talked about one matrix, and that is controllability Gramian matrix. And here similarly same kind of matrix comes into picture, and here I have little different term. In controllability Gramian matrix, if you check it, then here I have A and here I have B. In place of B, now I have C. So now in terms of this A and B, and using this integral, we are going to talk about this theorem. And again, this theorem gives us necessary and sufficient condition. Some theorem sometimes just give sufficient condition. We have already seen in case of Lyapunov theorem. But here, whatever things we have seen for controllability also, that is necessary and sufficient condition. And here this theorem for continuous time linear LTI system, it is again talking about the necessary and sufficient condition. So what we are telling, that this system is observable if and only if this matrix is non-singular, same like the controllability, just I have certain kind of rearrangement, and it is possible to guess this rearrangement since output is related to this matrix C, and due to that reason C comes into picture. Whenever we are talking about controllability, at that time somehow B matrix comes into picture, and due to that reason that matrix is involved here. So let us try to see something more. So first we are going to prove that if this is non-singular, then why I am telling that system is observable. So let us try to see that. Somehow I have told you that observability means I have to give guarantee that this particular equation C e power a t x 0 matrix equation, this is equal to y bar t, and I have already defined what is meaning of y bar t, that is y t, and all leftover term I am going to put, and I am going to multiply this and then again integrate it over 0 to t. Then what we will see that I have this kind of things. Now if w0 t1 is non-singular, and that is observability Gramian matrix, and if this is non-singular, then I can give guarantee that whatever equation that has unique solution. And that was my problem, that is it possible to estimate the initial condition uniquely or not. So if w0 t1 is non-singular, so we have involved w0 t1 in this particular equation, and after that we are assuming that this is non-singular, then this particular equation always has solution, because I know y bar tau now, and this particular part is also known to me. Now it means that if this particular term, that is observability Gramian matrix, if that is non-singular, then I am able to predict x0 uniquely, and then due to that region, or observe uniquely, and due to that region we are telling that system is observable. Now let us try to see the reverse, because this is if and only if condition. So first I have to assume first one, that whatever controllability Gramian matrix is non-singular, and then I have to prove that I can estimate x0. Now we are going to see that if that is singular, then what kind of problem comes into picture. So let us try to see that if that is singular, then somehow I have to create some kind of contradiction, that I cannot either able to estimate x0 uniquely. That is enough to prove that this w0 t1, that is observability Gramian matrix in terms of A and C, that should be non-singular. So again, if w t0 is positive semi-definite, because this, if you see the construction of w0, again here you can see that I have e power a t tau c, and similar kind of repetition here. So this term is always positive, but it might possible for non-zero value of x, because this is positive definite function. And how basically we are defining positive definite function of some matrix, then means I have some kind of positive definite matrix, and after that if we are going to generate some kind of positive definite function, at that time we are multiplying with x transpose. And if for only x equal to 0, that is 0, then we are telling that is positive definite matrix, otherwise we are telling that as a positive semi-definite matrix. So now first I have assumed that w0 t1 is singular. So it means that there exists n cross 1 non-zero constant matrix B, such that this kind of things happens. It means that I am going to map this particular w0 t1 to one dimension, and after that, in order to do that, I have multiplied both sides by this vector, and after that we are telling that even if this vector has non-zero value, then that equal to 0. And if that is the case, then C e power a tau v equal to 0. Now you can see that I have one of the test for observability, that you can put u equal to 0, and at that time I have x1 equal to 0. It means that from here, what I am telling, that suppose only one state x1 equal to 0, and x2 I have another thing, means I system is in such a way such that that is in rest. But I have this kind of condition C e power a t b equal to 0, and due to that reason I can tell that I have something even if I will assume x1 0 equal to v, due to this kind of condition y equal to 0. If I assume this kind of things, it means that two different initial state yield the same zero input response. So I have taken two different initial state, but I will get same zero input response, but that should not be same, because if that is same, then we lost the uniqueness, and therefore we cannot uniquely determine x0. So in this way one can easily prove. Thus x dot ax plus bu y equal to cx plus du is not observable. So in order to prove this, I have generated some kind of counter example in between, and after that we are telling that it means that whatever observability Gramian matrix, that should be non-singular. After that, what we are telling that we see from the above theorem that observability depends only on A and C. This can be deduced from the definition of observability by choosing ut equal to 0. So what we have seen in term at the time of controllability, using the notion of A and B, I can talk about the controllability. Here one can also observe that during the definition of observability, using zero input response, I can talk about observability. So there is no need to worry about ut. So just you can put ut equal to 0. It means that if you substitute ut equal to 0, then now from here you can see the differential equation x dot equal to ax plus y equal to cx. So if you play with a and c, then you are able to talk about observability. That is the meaning. Now let us try to see the when I have started this lecture, I have told you that concept of controllability and observability are dual with respect to each other. So try to understand the duality. So suppose you have some linear time invariant system x dot equal to ax plus bu, y equal to cx plus du, and I am assuming that the pair ab is controllable, and this is controllable. It is possible to show if and only if the pair a transpose bt is observable. So if this is controllable, ab is controllable, then always that implies the a transpose b transpose is observable. Now let us try to see the proof. So if ab is controllable, then there always exists some kind of controllability Gramian matrix that is non-singular. We have already seen this in the previous class. Now the pair a transpose b transpose is observable if and only if by replacing a by a transpose, c by b transpose in this particular equation, because this is the condition for the observability, and I am telling these two pair are observable. You can see here a is coming from system matrix, b is the input matrix. So here I am not talking about the output matrix, but if I know the pair a and c, at that time I can create this kind of Gramianian, and in this Gramianian we are telling that pair a and c are observable. So here after that, in this theorem we are telling a transpose b transpose is observable. So I have to substitute a by a transpose and b transpose by c by b transpose, and if you will do, then basically this kind of matrix comes into picture, and this is again non-singular for all t. It means that what we are telling, that two condition are identical, and due to that reason everywhere if you have some proof that AB is controllable, so we have proved, we have stated some theorem. Now just you can replace A by A transpose and C by B transpose, then same kind of result holds. So using controllability you are able to talk about the observability, and due to that reason we are telling that both results are dual with respect to each other. So let us try to see, because You can see that if you assume WC is observable, then obviously again W0 is controllable, that comes into picture. So due to that reason, we are talking in terms of if and only if. And due to that reason, there is no need to prove next theorem. Just now everywhere you can do replacement. So what we are telling, if A and B are controllable, then A transpose B transpose are observable. And how to generate A transpose B means B transpose observable, you have to replace A by A transpose, C by B transpose. And due to that reason, I can state every result of controllability in terms of A and C. And due to that reason, this comes into picture. N cross N matrix are non-singular, then I can talk about observability. And at that time I have B, AB, A square B. So in place of B, you can put the C trans B equal to C transpose, and I have to check AB. So at that time I have to see the A transpose and B is C transpose. So at that time, automatically you can see that initially I have certain kind of things. I have B, AB, A square B, something that looks like some kind of row vector. Now that is transferred to the column vector. So again, C, CA, CA power N minus 1 comes into picture. And if this matrix is non-singular, it is possible to show that A and C are observable. So using just these two pair, you are able to talk about the observability of linear time invariant system. So please do the exercise. So I have created one hypothetical example when I was talking about controllability and observability. So you know the C and A matrix, please put that matrix here and try to check the rank. It is possible to show that that particular O matrix is rank deficient in that hypothetical fourth order or hypothetical system. Similar kind of exercise you can do that. You can take one mass, you can apply force, and after that create differential equation and just assume that output as a velocity. Again, it is possible to show that this matrix is rank deficient. And in this way, you are able to talk about the observability of linear time invariant system. Similarly, this kind of result we have already talked about the controllability A lambda and B we are talking. So I have already told you that everything comes into picture same fashion due to duality. Just I have to replace A transpose by A and B transpose by C. And due to that reason, everywhere here B transpose B is there, so C transpose C comes into picture. Similarly, this is observability Gramian matrix, and proof is directly due to duality. So there is no need to prove it. So till now, I have talked about the observability of linear time invariant system. Now, definition of observability for linear time varying system is exactly same as linear time invariant system. Just in case of linear time varying system, one more thing comes into picture, that is T0. Because in order to see the response of linear time varying system, I have to apply input. And I have to notice that at what time basically we have applied the input. And if I know the initial condition, then only I can talk about the future. So basically, what is crucial difference between linear time invariant and linear time varying system? If you see in terms of input output, then in case of linear time invariant system, I have to just worry about the U and X0, means input and X0 is the state. But in case of the linear time varying system, I have to worry about three things: X0, control input, and T0, when we have started the experiment. So now next theorem is again same like the controllability. So here you can see here that pair ATCT is observable at time T0 if and only if there exists a finite time T1 greater than T0, such that I have this kind of matrix and phi t tau is the state transition matrix of this particular autonomous path. x dot equal to at into x. So this is non-autonomous system basically, because at is explicitly dependent on time and this is unforced system. So we have calculated the state transition matrix, and if we calculate this kind of matrix here, basically this is matrix because everything is matrix, and if this matrix is non-singular, then I can able to prove AT and CT is observable. And proof is very, very straightforward, because I have already talk about the duality. So one can prove by duality. And here I have told in the previous class, when I was talking about controllability for linear time varying system, that I have two different ways. Either you can involve a state transition matrix, or you can skip the state transition matrix. But if you skip the state transition matrix, then what we have to assume that AT and CT is continuously differentiable at least n minus 1 time. If that is the case, then we have to check the rank of this matrix. So in case of controllability, I have M0, M1 and Mn minus 1, and we have generated M0, M1 and Mn minus 1 in the same way. Here, due to duality, whatever initially I have row kind of things, now that become column kind of things, and just we have to check the rank. So in this way, I can able to talk about the observability of linear time varying system. So again, proof one can do from the duality. So with this discussion, I am going to in the today's lecture. So again, somehow this is the end of the controllability and observability part. Now, next lecture onward, I am going to talk about the application of these two things, means controllability and observability. What does it mean? First, I will check that my linear time invariant system or time varying system is controllable and or observable or not. If that is completely controllable, then what we are going to do, that we are going to design the control action. If that is observable, but all states are not available, then first I can design some kind of algorithm that is called observer. And after estimating the remaining state using the observer, I can again talk about the controller design. So I have two different class, where one class people are telling that a state feedback based controller, and another class where people are telling that observer based controller. Because first, I do not know all state variable, I have not enough number of sensors such that I can able to measure each and every state variable, but I have certain kind of mathematical algorithm that is running inside computer or microprocessor that will able to estimate the state, and based on that estimation, I'm going to design the control action. And somehow that is end of this course. So I hope that I will take 4 more lectures that is related to controllability, means control design and observer design. So with this remark, I'm going to end the today's lecture. Thank you very much.